Hi guys and welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to show you how to strip down and reassemble a gate valve. You may have seen this valve in my previous video of the three common valves you may find in your home. So today I'm just going to give you a demonstration of how to strip down the valve, things to look out for, and how to use PTFE when using this type of valve. And let's take a closer look at the valve. Looking at the valve, this is a 22mm valve for 22mm pipework. So you have your feed in from this side and you have your feed out from that side. It doesn't matter which way this valve is fitted, so either side can be the direction of flow. We have two nuts on either side, and inside there is an olive on each side. So that is basic stripping down of a gate valve. Now to take it a little bit deeper, what you'll need is a adjustable spanner, and all you need to do with your adjustable is loosen off the top join there. That'll remove the gate from the valve housing. All you do is turn this in an anti-clockwise direction, lefty loosey, righty tighty. So now that is our gate valve stripped down one step further. So our housing now is stripped down. It's empty. There's nothing on the inside. You might be able to see the groove in the bottom there where the gate sits down into to stop the water passing. And we have our threaded section around the top. Okay, this is our gate itself. And unwind the gate. And this section of the gate can be removed from the spindle like so, turning it in an anti-clockwise direction. So that is our gate removed. Okay, these can be removed and a new one can be put on if there is a fault, if water is passing. Now taking it one step further, if you undo this nut on the top just below the wheel, undoing this nut on the top allows the wheel to be taken off. These can also be replaced. As you can see, it's a square fitting, and if that becomes rounded, the wheel is useless. It will not open and close the valve, so you may need to purchase a new wheel. So you may think now that that is our valve stripped down completely, but guess what? It's not. There's one more part we can take from this valve in order to carry out maintenance, and that is the spindle or the core that runs through from the top to the bottom, okay? And this can be undone from the inside here. There's two little grooves cut out of the brass to allow you to unturn that and remove the center spindle, and you'll need a pair of snap ring pliers for this. And all you do is insert the pliers into the grooves and turn in an anti-clockwise direction, enabling the center to be released from the housing. Okay, like so. Now that's out. Okay, there's the part holding the spindle in. As you can see, there's out comes the center of the spindle. So as you can see, that is our gate valve 100% stripped down. To reassemble the gate valve, you just carry out the task you've done, but in reverse. So start by putting the spindle back in the center, making sure that's the correct way, insert that, and with our spring pliers just tighten that up until it's securely in position, like so. Okay, Next thing we need to do is put our handle or our wheel back onto the top spindle and refit our securing nut like so. Okay, now I won't do it up tightly as time is getting on. Okay, that is our wheel put back on. Next we'll fit the gate, and that spins on in an anti-clockwise direction like so till it's all the way home. So that is the top bit of our gate valve assembled. Now this is where the PTFE tape comes in. So a lot of people using PTFE tape and compression fittings seem to think that if you put it around the thread there, then that'll stop any leaks, when in fact that's not correct. Once you've set your copper pipe into the olive, you then wrap round the PTFE tape around the olive, and then that gives a tight fit around, that gives a tight fit around the valve. So that is the correct way to use PTFE tape. You do not put it around the outside threads on a compression fitting, but you do however put it on an internal thread there. So if we just get a piece of our PTFE tape and we just apply a little bit of the tape just around the thread like so, put it on there because it's an internal thread, and then screw, making sure the gate valve is lined up correctly, then insert and tighten up our gate. Okay, snip that up with your adjustable. I don't really like using adjustables as they tend to slip. So that now is our gate valve almost assembled. Okay, next thing, you'd put your two pipes back on either side and tighten up the nuts at the end. So I haven't got any pipe handy, so I'll just pop that back on there like so. That one on there. Okay, like so. Now one thing I did forget to do is put the nut underneath the wheel, so that won't take long to do. Just make sure it's, if I'd have left that off and I'd have been installing this onto a piece of pipe, it could have failed and the water could leak out of the top. So I'll just take that off, put that on there like that, and that secures that spindle. Just nip that up all the way home, put our wheel back on and our locking nut. All I'm going to do now is just open and close the gate to see if it's functioning as it should. As you can see, that is closed all the way, and open it again. And it's now fully open. So that's how you strip down and reassemble a gate valve. Hope you've enjoyed the video and found it useful. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care. Bye-bye.